वाहे गुरु जी का खालसा, वाहे गुरु जी की फतेह। आई एम हरनियाल सिंह एंड टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू बी शेयरिंग विथ यू अबाउट द शहीदी गुरुपर्व ऑफ आवर फिफ्थ गुरु श्री गुरु अर्जन देव जी महाराज। ऑन द 14th ऑफ जून वी सेलिब्रेटेड द शहीदी गुरुपर्व ऑफ श्री गुरु अर्जन देव जी महाराज। इट इज द डे श्री गुरु अर्जन देव जी महाराज लेफ्ट देयर फिजिकल बॉडी। बिफोर मूविंग ऑन लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड what the phrase Shahidi Gurpurab means. Do you know what Shahidi Gurpurab means? Well, if you don't, Shahidi means martyrdom. It comes from the word Shahid, which means martyr. A martyr is someone who gives up their lives for what they believe is a higher purpose. It is a sacrifice made by the martyr for what they believe is a benevolent cause too. Now, moving on to Gurpurab. Gurupurab is made up of two words, Gura and Purab. Gura refers to the Guru and Purab means festival. So in other words, Gurupurab means a festival commemorating the Guru. So Shahidi Gurupurab is the festival where we commemorate the sacrifice of Sri Guru Arjan Dev Ji Maharaj by laying down their life. But we may ask, what is the higher purpose for which Sri Guru Arjan Dev Ji gave up their lives? Well, there were a series of events that occurred that led to the Shahidi of Sri Guru Arjan Dev Ji. However, the main lessons that the fifth guru teaches us is to always do the right thing without having any fear of the outcome, because God knows the truth. Apart from that, Guruji also teaches us to accept the will of God as sweet. Guruji recited the following Shabad during the time of their sacrifice. Tera kiya meetha lage, hari naam padarat nanak mange. The meaning is, your action seems so sweet to me. Nanak begs for the treasure of naam, the name of Lord. Now that we know the teachings that Guruji passed on through us through their Shahidi, it is time for us to implement these teachings in our lives. It is important that we practice these teachings, because only by practicing these teachings of the Guru will we attain peace, just as how Sri Guru Arjan Dev Ji taught Pai Lalu and Pai Nihalu. Let's have a look at this short sakhi on how Pai Lalu and Pai Nihalu learned that peace can only be attained by living our lives by following the teachings of the Guru. Now, do you know who Pai Lalu and Pai Nihalu were? Well, if you don't, Pai Lalu and Pai Nihalu were very learned and good entrepreneurs of the Guru's world. They were famous in the villages around Amritsar Sahib. People from far and near came to listen to their sermons and invited them to their villages to listen to their views. As a token of respect, they would offer Pai Lalu and Pai Nihalu plenty of money. Pai Lalu and Pai Nihalu found it hard to meet with the demands of those wanting their discourses. They were never short of invitations. Once, managing spare time with great difficulty, they, Pai Lalu and Pai Nihalu, went to Amritsar Sahib for an audience with Sri Guru Arjan Dev Ji. After the conclusion of the morning prayers, they spoke to Sri Guru Arjan Dev Ji. Revered Guru, Sikhs listen to our speeches with good regard and attention. In spite of all of the services we provide and the great respect we are held in, our minds are not at peace. Our minds are always troubled. Nothing is hidden from you. You know what is happening in our minds. Please, can you make us understand our shortcomings and explain why we do not receive the peace that we seek? Sri Guru Arjan Dev Ji kept quiet for a while and then told them, "Brother Sikhs, you give discourses in a fine way. Discourses cannot be given without knowledge. As such, you are quite learned also. You give expositions of the Guru's word and your own views, but you do not mold your lives in accordance with the words coming out from your mouth. You give interpretations and your own views to others. The Sikh who listens to your discourses molds their life accordingly. They attain peace. When you sermonize and give views, the Sikhs listening to the good words from your mouth offer you money. When you receive wealth and prestige, you forget that you also have to mold your lives according to the views that are expressed and attain peace. You cannot attain peace until you try to act upon the teachings in the Guru's word. It is essential to pray to God and live a good lifestyle. This is only possible when your lives are molded according to the Guru's teachings. Pai Lalu and Pai Nihalu, after listening to this, started acting on the advice of Sri Guru Arjan Dev Ji and attained peace. In whichever village they delivered discourses and their own views, they advised the Sangha to act upon the teachings that the Guru has taught to attain peace. Just as how Pai Lalu and Pai Nihalu led their lives in accordance with the teachings of the Guru, so should we attain a life filled with peace, bliss, and boundless happiness. Waheguru Ji ka Khalsa, Waheguru Ji ki Fateh.
Waheguru Ji ka Khalsa, Waheguru Ji ki Fateh. मेरा नाम थलासा कौर, मैं तीजी जमात विच पढ़दी हाँ। आज मैं गुरु अर्जुन देव जी दी एक कविता सुनान जा रही हाँ। बच्चे पिता ने अपने समय अंदर गुरु घर तैयार करवाए सोने, नाम बानी दे पारस दी छौ लेके पापी हृदय सन पावन बनाए सोने, कटनी करनी ना धर्म प्रचार करके हर थान दे धर्म दे झंडे झिलाए सोने। आठ बीच संपूर्ण आज होई ऐसी सिख के सदे खास खास इत्ते कल च पापल्ला पंचम पाचा ने गुरु चन्ना जी कृति अदास इत्ते पापा बुड्ढा जी सीस ते बीर रख के नंगे पैरी हरमंदर वल चल रहे सी संगता शबर गुरबानी ती परी जवन पंचम पिता छोड़ झुल रहे सी हरमंदर से जाके बीर साहिब जब प्रकाश कराया सी गुरु अर्जन हृदय गुरादे जानियो ग्रंथ अंदर जब मुखो फरमाए सी गुरु अर्जन जंगीर प्याले जब पी उतर डूब चुका सी नशे अंदर गुरु घर ते दोखिया टाड मौका जय बरी सी ओदो जनाब अंदर ओने गुरु दा कटल दा हुक्म दिता करम डरम दे दीन ईमान छटके चल पहे लाहौर दे वर सतगुरु पावन गुरादी नगरी महान छटके चेहरे फुला देखे मुजरा उदो माली जारिया सी गुलिस्तान छटके पीके जाम शहर डा अलोप हो गए वस्ता रस्ता जाचक जहान छटके धन धन श्री गुरु अर्जुन देव जी शहीदी ते सरताज धन धन श्री गुरु अर्जुन देव जी वाहेगुरु जी का खालसा वाहेगुरु जी की फतेह।